Hello everyone, we're back with some more Dragon Warrior here on the Classic Corner, on the Ion Game Corner. We are gearing up for the home stretch here. We're closing in on the end. As the King's gonna let us know. Let's see, how far to level 18 are we? 2677, yikes. Alright, so, where we left off last time. We see we're level 17. We tried to search our way through the Dragonlord's castle for Erdrick's sword unsuccessfully. The stuff in there is just a little bit too tough at this stage. So, the plan now is to travel to the area around Hawk's Nest, which is that deserted town with all the monsters in it. We're gonna fight around there until we hit level 18, and at that point, we'll probably try to take another run at Erdrick's sword. I mean, the main reason to try and get the sword now, I guess, is that it will make grinding to 20 probably a little bit easier. So, that's the idea there. The problem is that, I mean, most of the stuff in the Dragonlord's Castle, at least once you start getting to the lower levels of the dungeons, are really strong. So, I don't know if being 18 is going to necessarily help enough, but we shall see. And if you're just tuning in now, or you're watching this on YouTube after it's uploaded there, all of the other parts of the game previously are up also on the YouTube channel. That's youtube.com/IonGameCorner. I have a playlist set up for all of the videos for the Dragon Warrior playthrough, so you can feel free to check that out if you are so inclined. Watch me die an awful lot. Not gonna lie, I got super tilted at the end of yesterday's stream. It felt like every time I started to kind of find my way through and get close to the sword, something would show up and I wouldn't be able to escape from the battle. I don't remember there being demonites right in this area. I thought it was like they were all like south of Hawk's Nest. But that's fine. The guide that I was looking at suggests that I should already have Erdrick's sword by now, which I don't, but whatever. And from there, it's to level outside of Hawk's Nest till 18, and then go from into Hawk's Nest for 19 and 20. So that's the tentative plan. It's just, like I said, once we hit 18, we'll probably take another crack at securing Erdrick's sword if we can. Dude, stop healing yourself. Oh, I should probably double check my volume here. There, I realized I didn't have the game audio going. Caught myself this time before I streamed for 2 hours. least we're well past the point that, like, our attacks do probably 1.5 to double the amount that they can heal for. That's handy. Really? Yikes. Oh my god. That was 5 misses in one battle. Whoa! That healed me to full. I didn't think it did that much. Alright, we're running from this. I don't want to waste my time on a gold man who's only going to give me 6 experience at this point. I don't need the gold. That was kind of crazy. I didn't realize healed that much. I assumed it was only like double the amount that you get from regular heal. That's gonna come in super handy, I think. Maybe we'll venture a little south here. I mean, same thing like when I was talking about farming for gold in yesterday's video. Like, when you're farming for experience, like, you're just trying to find, like, that sweet spot of, like, rewards that are good and battles that you can win fairly quickly. Because, I mean, you can go to where some of the, like, tougher monsters in the game are, but, you know, if you're losing half your health every battle for slightly more experience, probably not worth it. Like, those things, like 20 experience for that battle is just not worth it, because it... Like, that's not bad. That's, you know, 2 turns, 33 experience. Like, that's so much better than the Wraith Knights. Maybe we'll cross the bridge, see how we do. Yeah, like, so that's 34, but this thing has the potential to put me to sleep and just draw out a battle. I'd love for it, like, to not put me to sleep one of these times. That'd be nice. So I think I want to fight in the desert, because I'm pretty sure, like, that desert is some of the, one of the spots that you have a higher percentage chance of finding a metal slime. I don't remember what the rewards are for beating a metal slime, but it'd be fun to do. Interesting. I think 18,000 might be the number I'm looking for. It's either 18 or 19. We can find that out. That capability. Yeah, 19,000. It's a slime that can't, that has spells. Ah. It's really hard to kill one of them. Like, they only have like 6 hit points, but you typically, I think you only do 1 damage at each hit, and so you basically gotta get 6 attacks off before it runs away. Thank you. It's weird that the knights around here are like one of the least threatening enemies, but they seem to give me the most experience. It's odd. I don't mind the wyverns, like, pretty easy. I mean, only 24, but they don't tend to prolong the battle with anything. So you got the Wraith Knights that'll heal themselves. You have the magic wyverns that'll put you to sleep, and then these things, the demon knights, that you'll just miss. Like that. Sleep never seems to not work on you. Seriously, so annoying. Sleeping. Good Lord. Wake up, dude. Wow, it's like 5 straight attacks. Are you serious? Miss. miss. Lots of misses. Oh my god. Hit the stupid thing. Alright, so we're over 18,000 now, so we're 1,000 experience away. So we're talking like around like 35 to 40 more fights. Just seems weird seeing the skeleton thing casting a healing spell on itself. I don't know why. Just feels odd. Boom. Stop spell. Slime. Can you put this thing to sleep? No. I think the metal slimes give you a ton of experience if you can actually kill one. I could be wrong about that, but... Thank you. Seriously. Under 300 away. Battles and we'll be there. It's amazing all the time I spent, like, grinding for gold and all this stuff, and now I just go, oh, I have 10,000 gold. And nothing to spend it on. This thing happens to drop 132. Power increased by 13. That sounds good. 15 maximum HP, I like that. Alright, so let's return to the castle. So, probably have enough for like 9 heal mores and the radiant spell I'm going to need to use. So, I've got 5 herbs. $2,971. That's actually not bad. I expected it to go up a lot more than that, but that's actually not bad at all. That's kind of where we started today at. So, 22,000 is the number? Alright, so we're gonna go make a run to the Dragonlord's Castle. I think the first time, I'll probably try and fight my way through a little bit and just see how it goes. Just to kind of get a gauge of where I'm at in relation to the stuff in there. Interesting touch that the Dragonlord's Castle is so close to the main castle in the game. I mean, geographically speaking. I guess geometrically, if you want to look at it that way too. These things aren't bad, they give me 40. Basically two shot on these things too, so. Things have heal more. Now that we know how that works, that's super annoying. I mean, we seem to be consistently hitting things for 30 plus, which is good. Real good, actually. Considering what we were doing before. Just gonna pace back and forth here to heal up my hit points with the, as much as I can. Oh. Yeah, I'm consistently hitting things for 30, and then I hit something for 19. 18? Jeez. That's better. Trying to conserve my magic points as much as possible. I mean, realistically, I could run away from these, and it would probably accomplish what I'm trying to do quicker, but, I mean, the experience points aren't going to hurt. Really counterproductive. Alright, maybe I'll just try running for a bit. See, now I get a nice run of no enemies. 27. Good enough. Able to fight a lot better than at 17. That extra damage is really coming in handy. Ouch. That hurt. Thank you. good. Wake up! Yep, game over. I mean, not a terrible run. So that was about a little under or over a third of the way to the next level, so that's not bad. No, it worked. It's just I have to have it connected to my phone's Wi-Fi all day. No. So, I mean, I'll use it here and stuff, but I... So I think we'll just try and run away from Axe Knights, since they can put me to sleep. Because I really don't want to waste magic points on Stop Spell if I can avoid it. Oh my god, seriously? Wake up. Thank you. asleep. Oh man. Start running again, so just to heal up to full. Of course. I only needed 4 more steps. Thank you. Ouch. Are there? Seriously? All right, I think this is a troll job. Yeah. Alright, so this is not the way I want to go. So now the question becomes, where do we go from here? Where? I know the guide wanted me to level to 20 before I try and fight the Dragon Lord. Came from that way. Yeah, we should probably just fight. But die. But die. Wow. Wow. There's some nice damage there. See if we can take a crack at him. Sure if I'm in the right spot or not, but whatever, we'll wander around. It's the worst can happen. He just hit me for 30. And then he just healed himself. All right. Fox Nest and level up. Hey, Ergen, how's it going, man? Not too bad, not too bad. Finally nearing the end of this game. Do another level or so of grinding, and then, make an attempt at the old Dragon Lord. So we're about 1,000 away now. Sure, we get the crit 3 attacks in.
Thank you.
maybe we'll take a run at the Dragon Mode if we hit 19. I have a feeling we'll get annihilated, but... I didn't realize it, but I was behind your mother for a little while today on my way home from work. Yeah. No. Well, I went all back roads because I heard Route 3 was bad and... No. I didn't realize until she's turning into her driveway. There. 15 hit points is pretty good though. That's hurt more, right? Yeah. Alright, so we're gonna return to the castle. I think these things just wouldn't even approach you at this point. we're gonna just run away from... I probably should have bought herbs. Just gonna run away from everything on the way there. Once we get into the castle, just to conserve. Or once I cross the bridge, probably. Dragons. There's the first one. Hey, there's Erdrick's sword again. Intersection, go all the way left and then down, go down the stairs. So this is, I guess, is the immediate intersection. Go all the way left, down, and then down the stairs. Go all the way up, then right. Side path to the next staircase.
So please don't get stuck with that. A, it's passive aggressive. It's not aggressive.
is. Any keys? Hey, that's handy. Hey, look at that, 504 gold to do nothing with. Kill your boss. Oh, a bridge. Oh boy, bridges. What could possibly be worse in here? No! We made it. Here goes nothing. Stand beside him. So I guess if you say yes here, he puts you in a treasure chest and you just die, basically. So I guess there's like an alternate, there's a game called Dragon Warrior Builders where it like takes as an alternate timeline as if you said yes and he just ruled the world. Will you stand with me now? Just use attacks, magic doesn't work. Make sure health is always above 50. Okay. That's funny, lol. Seven? Oh, below 50. I don't think this is a fight I'm gonna win. Take a chance? No, we don't take a chance. It's So that doesn't heal me to full. That's interesting. Three of these left. Oh, we did it! We found the ball of light. All the monsters are gone. Oh, it doesn't even slow me down. I mean, I could probably just return. This is kind of fun. Are there really no monsters in the game anymore? Anything else, or is that what they all say? What does that mean? Hey, it's credits time. Ah, for sure, I was gonna lose that fight. So while the credits are going, might as well mention, once again, you can go back and check out all of the previous videos from the Dragon Warrior playthrough. If you're watching this on Twitch, go to youtube.com/IonGameCorner. Obviously, if you're watching this on YouTube, you're already there. So this playlist set up for all the Dragon Warrior videos. We'll be doing another classic corner now that we're done with Dragon Warrior. We'll be doing a Super Nintendo game this time. So if you have any SNES suggestions of things that we should play, let me know. You can do that either leave a comment on the video or go on Twitter @IonGameCorner and leave some suggestions. Maybe we'll start it on Wednesday. So this is Monday the 15th, so maybe we'll start it on Wednesday the 17th. If not, I'll be doing Pokemon then, so... But either way, we'll have a poll probably up on Twitter with a couple of suggestions. Three or four games, maybe. And we'll see what people want to see. Does anything happen after the end, or is it just the end? I thought I remembered you could fight in this afterwards, but maybe... Oh, I think... So, your save, I think, stays at the same spot, so you can, go back and fight the Dragon Lord again if you really want to. But we're not going to do that. So, alright, that's going to wrap it up for Dragon Warrior, and it's going to wrap it up for the stream today. So, again, if you want to check out all the Dragon Warrior videos, youtube.com/IonGameCorner. Check it out there, and we'll be back with some more Classic Corner next time, Super Nintendo style. So, leave those suggestions, and catch you next time on the Ion Game Corner.